Hello, YouTube family. How's everybody doing? It's good to be with you again today. Hope y'all are doing good. I have another devotional for you. This one is entitled, The Slow Burn of Insecurity. I'm going to read from my Bible, Romans 8. 33-39. Who shall bring a charge against God's elect? It is God who justifies. Who is he who condemns? It is Christ who died, and furthermore, is also risen. Who is even at the right hand of God, who also makes intercession for us? Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword? As it is written, for your sake we are killed all day long. We are accounted as sheep for the slaughter. Yet in all these things, we are more than conquerors through Christ, through him who loved us. For I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other created thing, shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. Okay, that's the Bible reading. Now the devotion. How would you answer if someone were to ask, do you feel good about yourself? Would your thoughts be filled with self-doubt and second-guessing, or would you be able to stand tall and say, yes, I do? There are many behaviors and attitudes that clearly cross boundaries, such as unforgiveness, adultery, and greed. But insecurity is different. It's more like a slow flaming burning just beneath the surface, influencing our thoughts and subtly harming us from within. This issue is harder to identify, but it's powerful and can impact how we respond to God's call. What do we mean by insecurity? It's a feeling of inadequacy, often compounded by a sense of complete helplessness, purposelessness, disapproval, or rejection. All of these things can slowly accumulate and weigh us down if we don't learn how to identify them. Try spending time today in earnest prayer and honest self-discovery. Ask the Heavenly Father to shine His light on any area of insecurity that may be a burden on your heart. Let Him remind you just how special you are in His eyes. After all, our value comes from being God's children, and that will never change. Amen. Yes, I love being a child of God. Yes, love having God with me to lift me up. I hope you all enjoyed the reading. And until I read to you again, God bless you all, and goodbye.